Azai, goedemiddag allemaal. Lekker om jullie vanmiddag allemaal weer te zien. En lekker om samen te wees in die vrijdagmiddag op Live at 5. Het is 4 september vandaag en ik weet dat het voor allemaal een baie bezige week was. Het is een heerlijke, heerlijke achtermiddag in Louis Trigaard. Ons het wonderlijke reën gehad hierdie week. Ons is rechtig die heren daarvoor dankbaar. Alhoewel dit baie lekker is om die sonnetjie bietjie vandag te sien. En ek hoop dat julle 'n godsvrugtige en 'n geseënde week gehad het. Dat alles goed gegaan het met julle en julle gesinne. En ja, so as julle inskakel, sê hallo, hallo Benny, good to see you this afternoon my broer. Hallo David, daar op die lugmagbasis, Linda Burger, welkom julle, hallo Elna van Aard, welkom. Dankie vir die inskakel, good to see you guys, it's really good to be with you this afternoon. On this lovely, lovely Friday afternoon. Hallo Robert en hallo Elsie, gaat het goed? Good to see you, goed om julle te sien. En hallo Heidi, daar in Pretoria, lekker om jou te sien, goeiemiddag, goeiemiddag. En ja, ek hoop julle het 'n lekker koppie koffie en na die julle week, een lekker rustige vrijdagmiddag, so lekker die voeltjies wat hier buiten sing, en na die lekker koue die week en die goeie reën, so ons dankbaar vir die son wat so bietjie uit is. So ja, dit is die 4 September en regtig somer is bykans hier. Middag Annelie, gaat het goed? Hoop, goed om jou te sien. Hallo Derek, lekker om julle te sien. Welkom, dankie vir die inskakel vanmiddag. Heerlik om saam te wees weer met julle allemaal en ons gee dit so kansie vir mense om in te skakel, vooral, jy weet, vrijdagmiddag na werk in die dorp waar mense 5 uur klaar maak, dan is dit dan maar 'n bietjie 'n gejagery. Hallo Joe, goed om jou te sien. Om Frans, lekker om jou te sien. Dankie vir die inskakel. Hey Stefan, daar is jy ook op die lig. Goed om jou te sien. Lekker man. Soos ek gesê het, lekker vrijdagmiddag. Die sonnetjie is heerlik uit. Kinders het vandag geswem, kan jy glo. Hallo Bronwyn, goed om jou te sien. Goeiemiddag. Ek weet nie, die water lyk vir my nog 'n bietjie koud, maar ja, die eerste klanke en geure en reuke van die somer begin so stadig kom. Middag om Dave, goed om jou te sien na die Weskaap uit, en hallo Woeda, lekker om te sien, dankie vir die inskakel julle, en goed om saam met julle te wees, soos ons 'n bietjie gaan induik in wat ek glo die komende tyd vir ons voorlê. Ek hoop het gaan goed met julle huise en allemaal en allemaal gezond is. I hope it's going well with you in your homes, your families all doing well. And we're going to share a bit around the word of God and the purposes of God for our times as we come to almost the end of 2020, September being having already started. It's tremendous how quickly this year has actually gone by. So yes, thank you for tuning in. Ons wacht nog so vir 4 of 5 mense. Dan sal ons bykie daar oor begin gesels. Hallo Ogina, goed om jy te sien. Hallo Rian, ons gebede saam met julle daar vir pa Derek en julle op hierdie stadium vertrou julle regtig die Here vir 'n wonderwerk waar hy in die hospitaal is en ons gaan sommer saam met hom bid vanaand, saam met julle bid vir hom vanaand. Maar goed om jy te sien Rian. So is hier nog so 'n rapsie kans vir mense wat inskakel wat 5 uur eers klaar maak met werk, so ons gaan nog so 'n bietjie tyd aan hulle gee, dan gaan ons begin. Ek hoop julle het 'n lekker koppie koffie en dat julle 'n heerlike rustige middag gehad het tot dusver. En ja, loof die Here vir sy goedheid man, loof die Here vir sy goedheid. Ons is lewe in baie opgewonde tye eintlik. Jy weet, ek glo, I believe we living some of the most exciting times as Christians since creation. I believe that we are preparing for the greatest move of God. Ons maak gereed vir die grootste werk of uitstorting, werking van die Heilige Gees in die wêreld. And even with that being said, many people have in the past have been part of great moves of God, and we have the opportunity in this generation at this time to be part of the greatest move of God, the last harvest, the final season, I believe, as we enter this next phase in the world. And the whole world has actually gone into a bit of a crisis, but I believe that we are preparing for a mighty, mighty revival. A machtige, machtige herleving. A machtige, machtige uitstorting van die Heilige Gees. A mighty move of God that unlike that has been ever seen before. That being said, middag Tannie Minke, lekker om Tannie te sien Tannie Minke, en welkom, dankie vir die inskakel. That being said, I also believe that as Christians, we are carriers of light, carriers of hope, carriers of the glory of God. As Christene is ons draers van lig en draers van hoop, en draers van die heerlikheid van die Here. My wêreld, al die duifies en alles wat so vlieg, is allemaal te prachtig, man. Daar is hy, Christelle bring vir my 'n koppie koffie, so ek hoop julle koffiekie is lekker reg al klaar, dankie my hande. En ja, daar gaan ons 'n bietjie inspring en wat ek glo vir ons voor is vir hierdie middag. So, Ik hoop jullie allemaal daar. So ek ons begin een beetje, ons gaan gesels oor Jesaja 60 en so klopie jare terug, a couple of years ago, everywhere I went, the prophetic word, that was a buzzword in the church was Isaiah chapter 60 verse 1. It says, arise and shine, for your light has come and the glory of the Lord is rising upon you. En dit was een van die profetiese woorde wat in ons gemeente baie sterk naar voren gekom het. En middag Rita Jordaan, lekker om jou te zien en dankie voor die inskakel. Het was ook een van die profetiese woorde in ons eigen gemeente wat geweldig resoneer het. En daar is Susan Annemarie, welkom, lekker om jou te zien en dankie voor die inskakel vanmiddag. Het was een van die woorden wat geweldig resoneer het in ons geest. En dit wat die Heere gesê het is, in die Afrikaans het so mooi, ek wil het vir julle in die Nuwe Lewende vertaling lees. Hy sê so, en dis Jesaja 60 vers 1, staan op, laat jou lig skyn, sodat alle volke dit kan sien, want die heerlikheid van die Heere gaan oor jou op. Die heerlikheid van die Heere gaan oor ons op. En deel van die profetiese woord in daai tyd was om gereed te maak vir dit wat die Heilige Gees wil doen in ons generasie. And I believe that our generation is one of the generations that, one of the last generations that will be living before the Lord's return. And I believe all of us in our hearts, it resonates with us that we have to be ready for what God wants to do. En ons in die laaste paar jare was heeltyd 'n voorbereidingsseisoen vir die kerk en vir mense om die heerlikheid van die Here uit te kan straal in die wêreld en in die seisoen wat ons in lewe. En ek glo ons is nou daar. Ons gaan in ongekende tye in die wêreld was nog nooit in hierdie plek. Daar was nog nooit 'n tyd waar die hele wêreld in turmoil was. There was never a time where the whole world was in turmoil. You see, if we read it very clear, it says in Isaiah 60, oh wait, just the dog, Luna nie. Isaiah 60, when we read it, it says very clear, arise, shine, for your light has come and the glory of the Lord is rising upon you. But then it says these other words, it says, darkness, deep darkness, darkness will come over the earth and deep darkness over all the nations, but the Lord will be a light upon you. Jy sien, donker duisternis sal oor die nasies kom. Met die heerlikheid van die Here wat oor ons as gelowiges opgaan, is daar ook 'n donkerte wat oor die nasies kom. Daar's 'n duisternis. En het is my so, weet, duisternis word, goeiemiddag is my prins, so lekker om jou te sien. Duisternis word baie keer geassocieer met eintlik 'n lack of insight of dwaase besluite. En as jy nou kyk na ons regering en wat aangaan in ons land en basies al die lande in die wêreld, dan sien ons dat die besluitnemings van regerings so absoluut chaoties was, so slegste besluite geneem het vir die land of vir mense wat moontlik was. Maar jy sien dit is daar's 'n donkerte wat oor hulle verstand gekom het. Paulus sê dit so in Efesiërs 5, praat hy van hulle verstande sal verduister word, of die insig van mense sal verdwyn. Hulle sal eintlik dwaase besluite neem. Ons het Woensdag gepraat dat ook een van die tekens van die tye van die einde van dae is dat die boosheid gaan toeneem. Eintlik dat gewelddadigheid en kriminele dade gaan toeneem. Daar gaan 'n kriminaliteit in wêreldwyd toeneem en dis een van die tekens wat Jesus gesê het gaan gebeur. In Matteus 24 vers 12 is baie duidelik daaroor. En dit beteken eintlik dat ek en jy as kinders van die Here nie deur dit moet geskok wees nie. Ons moet dit eintlik verwag. Ons moet eintlik gereed wees daarvoor, want vir baie jare was die gees van die Here besig om die kerk en my en u as gelowiges voor te berei vir hierdie seisoen. The Spirit was preparing the body for this season. The Holy Spirit was working within our hearts so that we can be the carriers of the glory of the Lord in this coming season. As darkness covers the earth and deep darkness the people, we will be the light of God's glory. We will be the light in the world. We will be the people carrying hope and the people carrying life. You see, we must not get confused. Let me quickly read this portion just through, and it says, arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon you. Darkness will cover the earth, and deep darkness the people. But the Lord will be a light shining upon you. His presence will be with you. Nasies sal stroom, nations will stream to your light. Nasies sal stroom na jou lig. En konings van die glans van die nuwe dag wat vir jou aangebreek het. Kyk rondom jou, hulle kom almal by mekaar. Jou seuns kom uit ver lande. Jou dogtertjies word op die heup gedra. Jy sal dit sien en jou oë sal blink. En jou hart sal bons van vreugde. Die rykdom van die see sal na jou gebring word. En die rykdom van die nasies sal jou besittings wees. Middag dan die Rita om Adrian lekker om te sien, hallo is Iris, lekker om jou te sien. Jy sien, as ons hierdie gedeelte lees, dan sien ons, duisternis gaan hierdie lig oorweldig nie. En dis die waarheid. Al lyk dit soms of duisternis oorwin, of duisternis wen, is dit nie die waarheid nie. Die waarheid is die lig van die Here wat binne my en u lewe skyn, gaan in hierdie duisternis oorwin. Ons gaan deur hierdie duisternis. We will overcome all darkness. Darkness will not be conquering light. Light will always conquer darkness. Lig sal altyd die duisternis oorwin. En al word die omstandighede jou donker, woon die lig van die Here binne in jou en my. En dit beteken ek en u sal deel wees van die oorwinning van die Here in hierdie tyd en in hierdie wêreld. Hierdie wêreld gaan deur dinge gaan, but thank God, light always wins darkness. Ons moet dit vergeet nie. Maar partykeer is dit so dat ons word oorweldig deur die omstandighede en ons harte word negatief en ons vergeet eindelijk, as ons die einde van die boek lees, vergeet ons wie wen. Dis die ruiter op die wit perd en sy bruid saam met hom en dis die kerk van die Here Jesus. Dis die ruiter op die wit perd wat uiteindelik die oorwinnaar in hierdie stryd gaan wees. Middag Loret, dis die Here Jesus en ek en u saam met hom. Hy gaan die oorwinnaar wees. En al lyk dit soms onmoontlik vir lig om te wen, wil ek u wabel, lig wen. Dis verseker so. Jy sien die Here in die einde van die begin gesien in die begin van die einde en hy het bestem dat ek en jy in hierdie tyd moet lewe. Ons was miskien salig onbewus, maar ons was ons hele lewe lank nog in 'n konflik. Jy sien die woord sê in 1 Johannes 5 vers 19 dat hierdie wêreld in die mag van die bose vasgevang is. Jy sien ek en jy is vrygekoop deur Jesus Christus, so ons is nie meer in die mag van die bose nie, maar hierdie wêreld is nog in die mag van die bose. En ek en jy is soos God se agente van vryheid om mense los te maak. God se agente. En een deel van dit is dat partykeer as jy in 'n konflik is, ons het op die grens gewoon in daai tyd toe die Namibiese Angola oorlog aan die gang was, die grensoorlog. En vir mense toe ons in Suid-Afrika gewoon het, was ons salig onbewus dat daar 'n konflik aan die gang was, dat daar 'n oorlog was. Ons was salig onbewus as kinders dat daar ooit mense is wat skiet en daar is 'n bombardering en goed aan die gang. Totdat ons op die grens gaan woon het in Rundu, teen die Okavango rivier. We lived at the border in Rundu, at the Okavango river, and between in the border conflicts, and which was basically from the early 70s up to the late 80s. And you know, we were totally unaware, living as children in South Africa, that there was even a war. Until we moved to the border and we lived on the border, and you know, we were part of the war. Dit was vir ons 'n groot skok om die vegvliegtuie te sien en die bommings wat aangaan en party aande die krag afgewees en dan was daar spervuur gewees en ons was totaal geskok gewees om te weet daar's eintlik 'n oorlog aan die gang. But while we were living in South Africa, we were totally unaware of it. Living at the border in Namibia, we were confronted with a whole different reality. We have always been in a war. As Christians, we have always been. Paul says it very clearly in Ephesians chapter 6, that this is a battle. We are on a battleground. And we are part of the battle every day, but we do not realize it because we're not maybe on the forefront or the front lines of the battle. But in the days we are going, every child of God will be moved to the forefront of the battle. Jy gaan dit beleef in jou werk, jy gaan dit beleef in jou gesin. You will have to stand for the Lord. And we are going to the front lines. And this is a battle, but praise God, we have already the victory because Jesus conquered sin and death. He is the ultimate conqueror. And therefore, in his victory, my and your victory is secure. Maar ons moet nie geskok wees dat daar 'n konflik aan is nie. And that's the battle for men's souls. As we enter into this next season, is hierdie die battle vir mense se siele. En soms besef ons nie, ons is deel van 'n weermag. Ek en jy is deel van die Here se weermag in hierdie wêreld. Ons is opgeroep as sy soldate, ons is opgeroep as 'n magtige weermag. Die grootste weermag in die hele wêreld is die army van die Here, van alle nasies, volke en tale. En ek en jy is deel van hierdie wonderlike army. We are part of this wonderful move of God that will capture the hearts of the world. Even if darkness increases and deep darkness over the nations, the Lord will be the light shining upon you. Die Here is die lig oor my en u. Ons familie sal lig beleef. Ons familie sal seën beweeg. And therefore, we have to declare that over ourselves. Thank you, Benny, also for that. I see it now there. Yes, and it's also a worldwide move of God. And for many years we were maybe not aware of the war, but we have moved to the front line. Ons het vorentoe beweeg. En jy sal besef dat die Here in hierdie laaste paar maande, kyk na jou eie hart, look at your own heart, that God has been quickening a passion within you. God has been quickening, yes, the love within you, but he's also been quickening you to be awake. I have found that although all the stuff that has happened with the lockdown and also the government regulations were detrimental to the economy of South Africa and to many nations in the world, the decisions was really bad. You just have to look at the American situation to understand that the lockdown had caused a lot of inner hatred and frustrations to surface. But the point I want to come to is this, that as Christians, God used this time to have us refocus. And this is what we need to realize. Ons het hierdie tyd gehad om ons prioriteite reg te kry. You know, we were completely caught up in sport. We were a nation captured by sport. Everything was sport, sport, sport. Rugby, cricket, the Super 7 series. And then it was Super Cricket. And also it was the Formula 1. Al hierdie goed, ons lewe was behep en sport behep. We were completely captured as a nation in the hearts and minds in sport. Apart from that, also into entertainment. Our nation was flooded with all the American entertainment and all other stuff of and entertainment that really became an idol in people's lives. And during this time, God actually took us on a detox. Die Here het ons op so 'n bietjie van 'n detox gevat as Christene. En ons het so eintlik het hierdie goed van ons afgeval. I just see with the school sports that actually came to almost nothing this year. It caused parents to refocus. And just before the lockdown, we had so many families who couldn't attend events because it's the hockey there and the tennis here and the cricket here and then rugby there. And so it's all the time busy, 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 busy. And we didn't notice that we were captured. But God used this, the whole corona pandemic crisis, God used as a reset button to cause you and me to refocus our priorities. To refocus, jy weet wat, jou familie en tyd met jou kinders en tyd met jou vrou en tyd in die teenwoordigheid van die Here het belangriker geword. Time spent with God became a priority. And I believe the Lord has actually quickened our hearts to discern between His priorities and the world's priorities. And His priorities are very different. He brought us into a time of peace. In your heart, you have inner peace. He brought us in a time of quickening us. Since I've seen many people who, since their born-again experience, almost had a new born-again experience in this time. Where they really experienced God in their homes and God in their families, that they yet believe. And that God quickened their hearts. And many people were overworked, totally overworked, had a chance to really rest. And had the chance gehad om te rus. And I believe the Lord gave that break so that we can be prepared for the greatest move of the Spirit that the world has ever heard or seen. And you and I are part of that end time move. Ek en jy is deel van die beweging van die Heilige Gees. Ek en jy is deel van hierdie werk van God wat die wêreld gaan omvergooi in terme van dit wat hy gaan doen. We are part of the greatest harvest the world has ever seen. And as Christians, we need to just remain focused. Don't let the media steal your focus. I find the media, the news, have really become bad news. You see, the gospel is good news, but media has really become bad news. It only wants to hype up emotion. It's hyping up so much racial tension that all over the world, suddenly this BLM movement in nations that never had a racial problem, suddenly has racial problems. And that's the strategy of Satan. It is to cause division, to cause people to be offended in their heart and respond on situations and circumstances. It's not even their own. Middag Barry, lekker om julle te sien. And I want to encourage you, stay focused as a child of God. Child of God, stay focused. We are in a battle. Ons is in hierdie oorlog. Ons is deel van die weermag van die Here. Die Here skuif ons op sy front lines because He is going to use you to become a soul winner for Christ. He's going to use you to impact the lives of people that will for eternity be written and recorded in heaven that you were part of the army of God. Jy was deel van die army van die Here. Middag Carly, lekker om jou te sien. You are part, you are called, you are anointed to where you are. Jy is gestuur, jy is 'n gestuurde van die Here. En in hierdie tyd gaan ons die advancement van God se koninkryk sien. In ons generasie en in ons tye, soos wat ons nog nooit gesien het nie. And I believe that it would not be by spectacular ministers and preachers, television evangelists. It will be by the body of Jesus Christ. Many years ago, as I was waiting on God in a season of fasting and prayer, I had a vision of Jesus, and out of His chest came these rivers, these streams of living water, and it was a stream that flooded the earth. It was a stroom wat die wêreld gevloed het. Hallo Sari. And from the stream, when I looked at it, Jesus spoke to me and said, in this last season, it will be the body of Christ that will flood the earth with the glory of God. And that's you and I, my friend, vriende, dis ek en u. En ek en u is geroep deur die Here vir 'n tyd soos hierdie. Sal ons dan nou omdraai? Nee, ons is gebore vir 'n tyd soos hierdie. Jy is nie per ongeluk in hierdie tyd nie. Jy weet die kanse vir jou om hier te wees as 'n net basis met swangerskap is al 145 miljoen teen 1. And God has called you to be here at this time. Middag Jacques, lekker om jou te sien. We are at this time called to be here. Ons is geroep vir 'n tyd soos hierdie. Ons is toegerus vir 'n tyd soos hierdie. Die Here het my en jou deur seisoene van heiligmaking gevat en seisoene van pruning gevat. Seisoene waar die Here met dinge gedeel het in ons verlede en in ons lewe. Die Here het ons deur seisoene gevat waar hy ons toegerus het en gegroei het. Seisoene in die kerk en waar sy woord geïmparteer is in ons lewe. His word was imparted into our lives. And now it's the time to experience the outflow of God through you. Waar die Here die wêreld gaan pakteer deur my en u. En ek glo ons moet meer gereed maak daarvoor en dit begin verwag dat die heerlikheid van die Here gaan opdaag in jou universiteit waar jy sit in die klas, gaan die heerlikheid van die Here opdaag en daai persoon wat demon possessed is, gaan in 'n oomblik vrykom. Jy gaan daar in die skoolbanke sit en die heerlikheid van die Here gaan opdaag. Jy gaan by die werk sit en net jou werk doen en daai persoon gaan inkom by die deur en jy gaan jou hande op hulle en die Here gaan hulle genees. And so the kingdom of God will start to flood the streets. It will be in Shoprite and in Spar, it will be in Checkers, it will be in Pick n Pay that the glory of God will be made manifest through you and me. We are the army of God. We are the light of the world that overcome the darkness. And yes, deep darkness will be on the people. But before the Lord's return, there will be a glorious, great move of God. The greatest harvest of souls. And that is our portion. Dis my en u porsie. Dis my en u porsie. Hallo Johan, lekker om jou te sien. Ek en u is geroep deur die Here om sy heerlikheid uit te straal na 'n wêreld wat verlore is. En jy het daai lig. En dit maak nie saak waar jy is nie, jy het dit. You have it. And people are so discouraged. But praise God, we are encouraged. Ons is nie ontmoedig nie. Ons is bemoedig. Mense is so in a lull ingeval. But praise God, we are not in a lull. We are awake. Ons is geestelik wakker. Prys die Here. Ons is gereed vir hierdie seisoen en toegerus deur die Here. Toegerus om 'n goeie pa en 'n goeie ma te wees. Toegerus om ons kinders te lei. Toegerus om ons skole 'n impak te maak. Toegerus in ons werk om in ons werk en ons samelewinge impak te maak. And that's you and I called to reveal the glory of God. Light bearers of the kingdom. Yes, it is a battle. For sure that is a battle. Verseker is dit 'n oorlog. Paulus is dit duidelik en in die woord is dit baie duidelik. Jesus sê, ek stuur julle in soos skape onder wolwe. Dit is 'n oorlog. For sure it is. But thank God who has already given us the victory in Christ Jesus. Ek wil graag 'n skrifgie vir julle lees en dan gaan ek vir ons afsluit in hierdie middag en net dit al my gedagtes so 'n bietjie saamvat. En hierdie is dinge wat op my hart lê terwyl ek so op die Here wag en dink dat ons so aan die Here se woord kou en sê Here wat sê u vir hierdie komende tyd. Ek wil graag vir julle hierdie gedeelte lees uit 2 Korintiërs 2 uit en is 'n gedeelte wat Paulus skryf. En hy sê dit so kosbaar in hierdie gedeelte. Môre van Irina, lekker om te sien. Hoe gaan dit dan met tannie? Ek hoop dit gaan goed. Hy skryf dit so 2 Korintiërs 2 sê ek is vers 14. Ek is dankbaar teenoor die Here wat ons, omdat ons een is met Jesus Christus, altyd saamneem in sy triomftog. God wat ons, omdat ons een is met Jesus Christus, neem ons saam op sy triomftog. Ek en jy, deur ons versprei hy die aangename geur van sy kennis op elke plek. Ons is die welriekende geur wat deur Christus tot God opstyg. God is, oh, thanks be to God who always leads us into triumph through Christ Jesus our Lord. And we are the fragrance of Christ to the world. A well-pleasing fragrance, the next verse says, rising up to heaven. Weet jy, daar is maar niks so lekker soos 'n lekker parfum nie. Ek weet nie van julle nie, maar jong, iemand wat lekker ruik, ruik maar wragtig lekker. And when that smell and it comes into the room and that fragrance is there, it's just such a beautiful thing. And you are that. Jy is daai heerlike reuk. Oh, lekker. Weet, iemand braai vleis hier buiten, so dit ruik extra lekker hier by my. It's really, somebody's barbecuing not too far away from here, so it's really smelling nice. But I want to say to you that realize who you are. You are a child of God. You don't have to be afraid. You are no longer slave to fear. You're not a slave in a cord in the fear of darkness. You're a child of light. Jy's 'n kind van die lig. You're a child of God that carries the victory of Jesus everywhere you go. And yes, things will happen. The world is in darkness. But thanks be to God, we are walking in the light. And that's my prayer for you today, that God will help us to have the right focus in this time. That God will help us not to lose sight of the calling we have in Jesus Christ. We can so easily get captured by all the turmoil in the world. You know, this has been a very busy week. There's been a lot happening the last few days. We have people gone through a lot of stuff. But thanks be to God that He gives the victory in every situation. Today, as we speak, we've got a family whose father is very ill in hospital in Tzaneen. And we're going to pray specifically for them and come in agreement for Mary Ann's dad, Derek, who is at the moment in hospital. And would you pray and agree with me for the Lord to do a miracle in that situation? If I have it right, he's in a coma, and we trust God for a complete healing. I pray today, during the week, for someone who had a serious back injury and God completely healed them. And we've seen so many miracles this last year, last few months actually as well. But we trust God for a miracle for Derek today. So can we agree together in prayer? Father God, we pray for Derek today in hospital in Tzaneen, who has got a heart failure today. And Lord, we pray that your hand will touch his body, that he will be born again, God, but that he will be healed and find the opportunity to know Christ, to live out his purpose. He said, not an old man. I thank you, Lord, for, yes, intervening as we agree together with Mary Ann and Rian Slebush and their family, God, for her dad. We thank you, Lord, for your healing touch. I thank you for everybody watching today. Thank you for elke wat kyk. Ek dank you, Here, dat u elke van ons geroep het. I thank you that you lead us into victory. U lei ons in oorwinning in ons huisgesinne, in ons besighede, in ons werke, in ons finansies, in ons gesondheid, Here. That you lead us into victory in our families, God. That our families will know Jesus Christ. They will see the glory of God. They will experience the favor of the Father like never before. And Lord, we know this world is preparing for darkness, but we are preparing for the greatest revival the world has ever seen. We will see the nations of Europe turn to Christ. We will see the nations of our world follow Jesus. We will see the glory of God upon the faces of the saints of the Lord. That means our brothers and sisters in Jesus will be shining like the stars of heaven, as it says in the book of Daniel, chapter 12, verse 3, that those who lead many to righteousness will shine like the stars in heaven. I pray, God, help us to lead people to you. Help us to discern that this is the time to take up our call, take up our cross, and follow Jesus, become an evangelist, to reach the lost, to impact the world, because the greatest move of God is at hand as we are preparing for this next season. Thank you, God, that you hold us in your hand. In Jesus' name, bless our family today, watching everybody today who's watching with us. Thank you, God, that your hand is upon them, on their families. Lord, I pray for their unsaved family members, that they will know Jesus, that all these families, our families, will experience, they will smell the fragrance of Christ in our lives. They will smell the goodness of God. Lig aan die geur van die goedheid van Christus Jesus kry. I thank you, God, for healing. I just see there's someone here that has an anxiety about a diagnosis, and I thank you, Lord, that we don't have to fear any cancer diagnosis or any illness diagnosis. I thank you, God, for complete healing that's ours in Jesus' name. It's yours. Thank you, Father. God bless you. Mag die Here u seën in hierdie naweek, en ek hoop julle het 'n wonderlike naweek. Ons sien uit na 'n heerlike naweek. Ons het 5 dienste aan elke naweek. Vanaand is dit die jeug, en môre is dit in Pietersburg, en dan Sondag is dit 2 dienste, die vaste grondslag wat ook aan die gang is, en dan het ons nog 'n diens daarna. And we thank God for what he's going to do. We're looking forward to the glory of the Lord. It's taking control over the darkness of the world. You are a light. Enjoy your weekend. Thank you. Bye-bye.